Hey guys, welcome back to the Sky Area of Darkness. Last episode, we had to start the game again. I've changed some of my material, as you can see, some entrepreneurial seal, blah blah blah. In this episode, we actually gotta do this level properly. Now, what you want to do is actually get Rilharo on a good start here. So I'm gonna throw him probably here. Then he's gonna move all the way over here, so he can get over to this platform with these. Next, I'm gonna have him defend. For the next move, I'm actually going to get Dawn out and push Edna back. And that's going to be my turn. Probably thinking, wait, that's kind of weird. I'm actually trying to get out of the radius of each the archer and the mage so they can't actually attack me. Damage to Dawn's not really relevant at the moment, so I can just put it back in here for now. Next, I'm going to use Edna's ability to actually backdrop after using Impale to go back to the square here. Punk. Also, the leg seems to be fixed up a lot. Maybe this is this level that had it before, but we'll see what happens later. Hand against 3, by the way. So let's see, Blazing Knuckles. Also, Lara's got a bit of boost on his SP thanks to one of his items. I think it was a basics of 40 extra SP, which is... you're going to need it. Now I've used that as a shield, I'm actually going to take all these out in one fell swipe. I'm going to start doing it from here. Next, I'm actually going to pull Dawn back out. Actually, it's not going to work, I'll just wait next turn for that. So now we should be able to kill this ghost, whatever they're called, with a basic attack. And now we'll just wait on for Laharl to finish his part of the job. Go use Blade Rush and take out all these. Now the Mage and the Archer have significantly weakened. This one's weak against fire and fire. This isn't against ice. It's not too good for me, but oh well. Next I'm gonna send everyone and heal. I had the mistake of accidentally killing Edna before. I'm gonna go charge forward. But I think this is a bad idea and I agree with you. I can't take it back now. It's gonna be my turn. And it's pretty much gonna be... looks like she's gonna be a sacrifice at the moment. But let's watch. Watch what happens. And look at that, she survives. With that, I'm going to drag her back for a second and heal her again. You're going to have to be really careful with these heals too. That's not enough, but oh well. Next, we're using Impaler to drop back a square, followed by a retreat. After that, I'm going to send Dawn in to get some quick pullos off, actually. Keep it a bit back because in the radius of attacks. Oh, resistant any weak. And the leg is returning. It's stage, I can't help it. And I'm gonna throw Laharl forward. Man, this is bad. Yeesh. For a basic attack. After that, I'm going to send Vegeta forward as a blockade. And another Prinnies as well. That way they keep focus off the three on the back and aim for the Hyrule and the Prinnies. And that's pretty much my move. Vice is... yeah, this is what I thought would happen. Elias charged through his own forces to actually get through, followed by a wind. Ooh, yeah. I was hoping that wouldn't happen, but that's actually better in this case. Followed by a team attack to the blockade of the Prinnies. But of course. And still alive. Great. Okay, next I'm going to have to do an immediate heal. This is going to be a big heal, actually. We can do 3 squares. So the 3 I want to heal are Dawn, Edna, and I'm going to have to go with Valhara here. I don't want to move forward either, I want to go here. Yeah, be fine. And heal the 3. Yeah. Next I'm going to backspace them back to their original position so they haven't had a chance to move. And I'm actually going to have to do something with this guy right now. First off, use Dawn, Ice Ability. It's not going to do much, but hopefully it'll be enough for that. And the lag's kind of distracting me now. Yeah, there we go. Next, I'm going to use Laharl's Brazen Knuckles. Plus I'm moving Frenny out of the way so he doesn't get damage from this. Now I'm going to send out this pretty forward for a back attack on mid-boss, whatever, Vias. But actually, never mind. I'm going to send him forward here, put him in defense, to block this guy from moving forward. Then I'm going to put this pretty here to attack with Laharl, hopefully, and another pretty here. Okay, that's fine. All misses. Fantastic. In defense mode. Next, I'm going to send Edna forward and use Prinny Raid.
Drop dead.
So we can love Vias a bit, but not really. And after that, I end my turn. Now, if I'm lucky, Vias is just going backwards. Okay, he's going for the Prinny. That's better than I actually wanted, so thank you, Vias. Okay, I'm going to have to get rid of those two now, so I'm going to use Laharl for that. Even this Prinny here, actually. This Prinny's about to get killed anyway, so we'll just get him against Vias. And put this Prinny here. Next, Blaze and Knuckles again. What are the water graphics making that lag? Then we'll put Edna forward. Can't use Prinny Raid again, but I can do a basic attack. Then followed by a barrage of attacks and a defense from you, because I need to have one shield still open. Next, I'll move you forward on, and aerial forward will be here. And that'll be our turn. Once again, this is stage, I can't help it. So much water, the water effect just breaks it. And here comes the counter I was expecting. This will take out that Prinny. That's why we're going to have a defensive block here. Actually, now I think about that, just to make it be a bit more cautious, I'll put Dawn here. Just so he doesn't use Atomic Blast again. Now he will go for that Prinny, which I wanted. And put himself against the wall. Next, I'm gonna use this opportunity to actually get him surrounded by Laharl and Edna. There's an Impaler Strike and the Hurricane Slash Strike. Also, following the 3 will be Dawn's Ice Attack. And I'm designating Aerial as a healer for now. Also, this Peroni's kind of... I didn't actually think no one would survive, but... whatever. You can apparently go in the water, which is... actually, if Fires can do that too, that's bad. And I'm hoping he's got to be the meat shield for this hit.
Die.
Okay, it's not bad. Now, counters only happen if you do a basic attack on him. If you actually use a special attack, counters will not affect. Okay, 40, you might go for the ward after thinking about that. But that's fine, because he wouldn't survive another hit anyway. He's on 22 health. We go for another Hurricane Slash, and another Impaler if we have enough SP for Impaler. Probably don't. Yeah, we don't. Oh, we do, okay. So maybe Edna will get this kill, who knows, we'll see what happens.
Die.
One damage off. Okay, I'm just gonna try to restart the recording and see if I can actually get the speed back to normal. Guess not. But hey, at least we get to hear this at all.
But that was an error in judgment. I am too kind-hearted.
Liar! You were serious just now.
Why are we talking so slow?
Pathetic. Nothing's worse than a sore loser.
What repulsive little brats you are. I shall come to return the favor, so do not forget.
Alright, let's collect the spoils and head home. Prince, I need to use the restroom.
Master Edna ran away. Which means, dude, we're gonna have to carry all this. We're Master Edna's vassals, not the prince's.
Dude.
Edna's vassals are my vassals. And my vassals do what I say.
See, it actually works in that kind of, to be fair.
Now get to work.
Not there, though.
Dude.
Dude works fine.
Now, it's only until next bedroom.
Hello, foreshadowing character.
I guess you're right, dude. I'll get to work.
No, he doesn't suspect a thing.
I see. But still, how did he survive after drinking that potion?
Dracula?
If he fully recovers, this will become a difficult task.
Don't worry. If you leave it to me, the throne will be yours.
Are you sure you can deliver on that promise?
Yes. Remember, in exchange...
I know. When I reign supreme as the Overlord, I shall return it to you.
And that's the end of episode one, guys. You know, the actual end, not the Papyrus Wind's End.
The time has come for Prince Laharl to pay for all Now, Edna will fulfill the late prince's wish and succeed him to the throne.
I'm not dead.
So long, prince. Your humble vassal, Edna, will put your money and power to good use.
You're one scary girl.
Next on Hyperdimensional Demon Gal Etna, Episode 2, The Birth of Queen Etna. A new era of the Netherworld begins.
You're delusional.
Anyway, this is a good time to actually fix up all the problems with the recording. So after I save this, I'm probably gonna start another episode. Yeah, sorry, it's gonna be a single episode again for this. But yep, see you guys in the next episode. Goodbye.
Celestia, a world where beings known as angels live. The Netherworld, Celestia, and the human world. Legend has it that these worlds are connected. This is one of such nexuses between the Netherworld and Celestia. However, it is sealed by a gate constructed by the angels of ancient times.
You send for me, Master Lamington?
Yes, I did. Here, Flog, have a look. The flowers are in full bloom.
How beautiful! I love these flowers. They are simple yet so bright and lively. I want to be like these flowers.
Flog, listen carefully to what I have to say.
Yes?
As Seraph, I have orders for you, Angel Trainee Flom. Go to the Netherworld and assassinate the Overlord, King Krajewskoy.
Huh?
Episode 2, Enter Flom.
Well, I'm here. The Overlord's castle. I still wonder why the Seraph picked me, though. Master Volcanus would have been a much better choice. Not only that, but an assassination. What is the Seraph thinking?
Master Lamington. Master Lamington, are you here?
Why all the ruckus, Volcanus? You scared the birds away.
About the birds. I have an important question. Is it true that you sent Flog to assassinate King Krajewskoy?
Yes, it is true.
What did you do that for? King Krajewskoy is the ruler of that abominable, dirty, rotten Netherworld. If you want him assassinated, it would make more sense to send me. Instead, you pick that angel trainee. You think too highly of her. I am very aggravated by this.
That is exactly why you are not fit for this task. Besides, this is something that only a flaw can accomplish.
Whoosh! Potential! Min! But still, Is it all right for me to be doing this? The angels all say that demons are evil. But are they really? It doesn't seem fair to judge somebody based on rumors alone. Even if it's the Seraph's orders, I don't feel right assassinating somebody I don't know. Does that mean it's all right to assassinate somebody I do know? That seems wrong too. Can't kill strangers. Can't kill acquaintances either. Which means... oh...
Who are you? And why are you in my room talking to yourself?
Oh, I'm sorry. You scared me, so I accidentally... Huh? Is he a demon? There are demons this young? I didn't know that.
So who are you?
Me? Nice to meet you. I'm an assassin. Oops, I wasn't supposed to say that.
You're pretty dense, aren't you?
My, how rude, calling somebody you just met dense.
I think an assassin that tries to kill someone in his sleep is a lot ruder.
You're right. I apologize.
Is she really an assassin?
It looks like I failed this time, so I guess I'll be leaving now. I'll be back again. Please take care.
Someone! Get in here! Now! Why are you yelling at this time of night? Oh, did you have a nightmare? No, you fool! An assassin has infiltrated the castle!
Huh?
What happened to the Prinnies that were supposed to be on patrol?
Oh, they've partied themselves to sleep.
Those idiots! I'm gonna smack them! Wake them up now! We've got an assassin to track down!
Sorry about that lag. I fixed that at the end, but it's kinda too little too late. Anyway guys, see you guys in the next episode of The Sky, Hour of Darkness. We go check out Flon the Assassin. See you guys then. Yeah, kinda ended the episode already, but just, you know, doing it again so I can have that cutscene and make the episode a bit longer. Anyway, see ya.